to everyone. I'm Pantelis Kalaitzidis, the director of Volos Academy for Theological Studies. And we are here from Volos, my colleague Nikos, Dr. Nikolaos Asproulis, who is the deputy director, but he's presenting his paper in another room. Our colleague, Dr. Nikolaos Kouramenos, who works now with the Institute for the Religious Studies in Bologna, but still keeps his ties with Volos. And our former colleague, Katerina Pekridou, who works now with the Conference of European Churches. If I'm not mistaken, with St. Ignatius, we are the only European institutions. All the other presentations are dominated by the American institutions, but this is good. This is maybe the reality. So I wrote everything in order to keep time. Could you please? Yes, okay, it started. Founded in 2000, the Volos Academy for Theological Studies has been administrated since 2011 by a board of directors chaired by Metropolitan Ignatius of Demetrias and consisted of university professors as well as of prominent figures from the ecclesiastical, theological, and the wider intellectual field. During the last years, the Volos Academy has been officially recognized as a research center by the Greek Ministry of Education, and at the moment, apart from the main theological department, it includes five more specialized scientific research departments, like the Department of Chanting Art and Musicology, the Department for the Study of the Manuscript Tradition of the New Testament, the Department of Canonical Theology, the Department of Interreligious Studies, the Department of Research of Byzantine and Post-Byzantine Monuments. In parallel, it functions as an open forum of thought and dialogue between the Orthodox Church and the broader scholarly community of intellectuals worldwide, organizing a series of studies, international seminars, conferences, roundtables, and publications in cooperation with numerous other academic, scientific, ecumenical, and interreligious institutions and forums, publishing houses, as well as scientific journals, rendering thus the city of Volos and the local diocese an international meeting place for encounter and dialogue. Since its foundation, the Volos Academy has been pursuing the creative and critical discussion on the challenges the Orthodox Church is called to face today, like, for example, ecumenical and interreligious dialogue, modernity and postmodernity, secularism, church and state relations, religious fundamentalism, and more. It also sought to contextualize the message of the gospel in our time to ensure the creative and constructive role of Orthodoxy in the public sphere and to highlight the prophetic and eschatological dynamic of tradition in the dialogue with the anthropological, political, and other parameters of the Western modernity. The scholarly results of all these meetings have been published in Greek, English, French, Romanian, and other languages in various collective volumes, scientific journals, or individual books, as you can see on the PowerPoint presentation. In this respect, the Academy has collaborated with institutions such as the Boston Theological Institute, the French Institute in Athens, the Department of Orthodox Theology at the University of Munich, the Faculty of Theology at Heidelberg University, the Bosse Ecumenical Institute and the World Council of Churches, the Conference of European Churches, the Society of Oriental Liturgy, the Orthodox Theological Faculty at Babes Boliai University in Cluj-Napoca in Romania, the Chair of Orthodox Theology at the University of Münster, the Center for Orthodox Christian Studies at Fordham University in New York, the Romanian Institute for Inter-Orthodox, Interconfessional and Interreligious Studies, the Inter, in Cluj-Napoca, St. Sergius Theological Institute in Paris, St. Ignatius Orthodox Theological Academy in Stockholm, the Journal and the Ecumenical Center Istina in Paris, St. Andrews Biblical Theological Institute in Moscow, the Orthodox Academy of Valamo in Finland, the World Student Christian Federation, the Forum of European Muslim Youth Student Organizations, and more, I stop here because the list is too long. Among the topics addressed by the Volos Academy in previous academic years were Church and Eschatology, Orthodoxy and Modernity, Ecclesiology and Nationalism, Islam and Fundamentalism, Orthodox Christianity and Globalization, Christian Presence and Witness in Palestine and Middle East Today, Gender and Religion, the Place of Women in the Church, the New Synaxarion, the Leaves of the Saints of the Orthodox Church, Biblical Liberation Theology, Patristic Theology and the Ambivalence of Modernity, Lay Participation in Ecclesiastical Life, Church and State, Orthodox Christianity and Islam, Islam in Europe, the Participation of Orthodox Women in the Ecumenical Movement, Neopatristic Synthesis or Post-Patristic Theology, Can Orthodox Theology Be Contextual, the Place of Religion in the Public Sphere, Issues of Renewal and Reformation Facing the Orthodox Church, Refugees, Immigrants and the Church, Why is the Orthodox Doctrine of Theosis so intruding to Western Christians, the Reception of Palamism in the West Today, Metropolitan George Eulos of Pergamon, Person, Eucharist and the Kingdom of God in Orthodox and Ecumenical Perspective, political Orthodoxy and Totalitarianism in a Post-Communist Era, Eco-Theology, Climate Justice and Food Security, Metropolitan of Dioclea, Callistus Guerra and the Witness of Orthodoxy in the West, Theology and Disability in Orthodox Perspective, Voices of the Liturgy, Gender and Performance in the Early Byzantine Church, On the Late Ancient Syriac Models, New Testament Orthodox Hermeneutics, Orthodox and Fundamentalism, and more. In addition, the Volos Academy for Theological Studies has established an online digital Orthodox Theological Library with free access to books, scholarly reviews and periodicals, with abstracts available in Greek, English, and Greek and English. Thanks to this initiative, the Volos Academy has been honored to participate in the Global Digital Theological Library. Moreover, the Volos Academy has the honor of coordinating an informal Orthodox theological network with 9 at this moment centers, institutes, academies, or university faculties of Orthodox theology. And that is the Orthodox Christian Studies Center of Fordham University.
1 minute.
Yes, I'm finishing. The Chair of Orthodox Theology of Mister University, the Romanian Institute for Inter-Orthodox, Inter-Confessional and Interreligious Studies, the Inter, in Cluj-Napoca, St. Andrew's Biblical Theological Institute in Moscow, St. Ignatius Orthodox Theological Academy in Stockholm, the Institute for the Study of Culture and Christianity in Belgrade, the European Forum of Orthodox Schools of Theology in Brussels, and the Center for the Philosophy and Theology in Trebije, Bosnia and Herzegovina. This network, with the blessing of local bishops and a series of biennial or 3-year conferences, seeks both to critically and self-critically approach our tradition and to underline the ecumenical openness of Orthodoxy and its interactive readiness to respond to today's challenges in the light of the gospel and the fathers, but also in a way that fits the concerns and language of our time. These networks, and this is my concluding sentence, this network has so far organized 5 international conferences whose topics appear in the PowerPoint presentation. Finally, the Volos Academy for Theological Studies has also decisively contributed to the significant presence of Orthodox theology at the European Academy of Religion in Bologna, a research initiative put forth under the auspices of the European Parliament already since its foundation in 2016. That's for the moment. Thank you very much.
Thank you.